reporting. And now let's go to Asha Rangappa, former FBI special agent, and Mark Preston, our senior political analyst. Asha, how damaging is this development? We find out that the guy who was leading the Hillary Clinton email investigation not only turned down the wording significantly, but then was on the Mueller investigation and was saying negative things about Trump.
Yeah, I think Laura had it right. This is bad for optics. It's you never want to give anyone in the outside the appearance that the FBI is biased at all. One of the things that they train you very strongly, they emphasize all the time, is that perception is reality. Mm-hmm. And you always have to maintain the utmost objectivity. So, you know, I think the changing of the language, you know, it was changed to actually reflect what was the final conclusion. And Comey is a lawyer, and he wanted it to be accurate, and it was accurate based on what he was saying. But yeah, it doesn't help Mueller's case that this agent was on there and has this history.
Right. And Mark, you know, look, this has got to be music to the president's ears, right? Mm-hmm. He has repeatedly called this investigation a witch hunt. Lest you forget, here he is.
This Russia thing with Trump and Russia is a made-up story.
The entire thing has been a witch hunt.
There's been no collusion, no obstruction, and virtually everybody agrees to that.
The Russia story is a total fabrication. It's just an excuse for the greatest loss in the history of American politics.
Mark, look, this is music to his ears.
Not only is it music to his ears, but it's also music to those of his supporters who are looking at the investigation right now as it's being politically driven. You know, there's two ways to look at this investigation, and I think Jeffrey Toobin often talks about this. There's the legal ramifications, right, which is the path that we should be looking at, and then there's the political ramifications, which in many ways is what's clouding and coloring what's happening legally right now. So, absolutely right. Optically, it does not look good, but there is something to be said that this agent was dismissed as soon as it was found out, and the investigation continues on. It shouldn't be used as it will be. It shouldn't be used as a distraction, as a shiny object off in the corner to try to take our attention away from what they're really trying to discover.
And Ash, let's talk about the other story out here, because the president is in a battle with the FBI right now. One of the tweets this weekend saying, after years of Comey with the phony and dishonest Clinton investigation and more running the FBI, its reputation is in tatters, worst in history, but fear not, we will bring it back to greatness. What's the reaction? You know, you were a special agent. Running the FBI and its reputation is in tatters, the worst in history.
Well, I think the president should read up on his history, because I think the FBI had some dark moments in the past, and this is not one of them. It's a very professional agency right now. And I'll say that, you know, when I was in the Bureau, there's a lot of stuff happening on the outside. Agents keep their heads down, and they do the work. They take the facts where they lead them. They stay professional. They present the evidence to the prosecutors who are going to decide if a crime has occurred. So I think the DOJ and the FBI do their jobs, and, you know, I don't think that they want to get in a fight with the president. They don't want to politicize the FBI at all.
And yet, of course, with this news about Peter Strzok, of course, Mark, there is politicization here. But also, this is the president continuing to go after American law enforcement, FBI, CIA, U.S. intelligence.
Absolutely true. And in fact, you know, we've just been noticed now that there's going to be a news conference tomorrow where you're going to have at least 10 members of Congress that are coming out, and they're asking questions about how the FBI conducted their investigation into the Clinton server situation, as well as Donald Trump and supposed meddling with Russia right now. So now what we're seeing is the conflation and really the tying together of two very separate investigations, but yet we're seeing President Trump's allies on the outside and certainly in Congress right now trying to put them all together. And when you do that, you're creating a lot of white noise, which creates even more confusion right now, Aaron.
All right. Thank you, Mark, Asha. Thank you both. And next, breaking news, the Supreme Court handing Trump a major victory, and it is on the travel ban. It's going ahead, and it's official. Trump calling